That? I think that was a mistake. Yo, guys, you want to move to a good-ass village? Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Atom Rolling Playing Game. I mean, never mind. Today, ladies and gentlemen, I'm excited. We're gonna be building our base! Well, technically speaking, the base is built. The thing is, we need to repair it, because we just have a hut. I mean, we have a beautiful house. We have a deep tent. We got a deep sex dungeon, boy! And, well, to be honest with you, that dungeon at the moment requires some furniture. So, there is a way that you can create yourself a place that you will call your own home. Oh, what the fuck? Hello? Who the hell are you? I didn't hire any chicks here. What the shit is happening over here? Yo, let's find out. Okay, moving on. I think I've left actually some items in the storage? I'm not sure. I know one thing for sure. We need to find a way to repair this base. Standing in front, you see Diana, a girl from Dan's factory. The girl is swerving. Wait, what? Hello, it's you from the factory. My name is Diana. Do you remember me? Sasha and I, we've moved here now, setting those new lands. I remember you. You look much better now. Mention that the face were acquainted one more time, and then those will be the last words. Mention the fact that we are acquainted one more time, and that those will be the last words to come out of your mouth. Wait, isn't that the woman that had the mask? There was on the side of Dan's factory, there was a woman and a guy on the side entrance. And we have figured out that one of the guards was actually a woman. Is that her? I remember you. You look much better now. Smiles shyly and tooks away a rogue look of hair. At least here I don't need to pretend to be a man. Yeah, that's her! Like I did in the factory. I forgot what it is like to wear woman clothes. Well, it becomes you. Wanna catch up? Now you have time to get used to them again. I'll be better going. Okay, let's go with the first one. Well, it becomes you. Wanna catch up? What did you want to say? What are your plans now? Smiles. Oh, it's hard to say. It's nice here. It's so nice here and quiet. We've built a nest here. Make it all cozy and clean. Well, as clean as it gets around here. And when, who knows, maybe one day we'll have kids, a real family. That's nice. How do you find life here? Beyond our wildest dreams, we're so lucky to have found this village. Okay, that's nice. Right, so any gossips around? No, I don't think so. Okay, can I great communism, red phoenix could rise again from the ashes. Okay, I don't care about communist fucks. Oh, she got the perfume, of course. Obviously, she is a woman. Right. Okay, well, I'm afraid it's time for us to go. It's so nice they actually moved it to my base. Don't you worry. You'll be safe here. You'll be guarded by the best mercenary in the fucking remains of modern Russia. That's nice. That's actually nice. It's cool that somebody actually from the previous chapters, from the previous episodes, have actually appeared in this location. Okay, who the fuck is this guy? As this guy, okay. Smoking his cigars, dozing walks somewhere. He looks busy, but when he sees you, he smiles and waves. Hello there, soldier. What's new in the settlement? Oh, only you and Pasha and the technician. No matter. Once we settle here, people will come. Yeah, sure. You think on visiting the central base after we threw? To be honest, I don't know. I grew to love the wastes, and my fake trading profession really becomes my trade risk. Freedom, high adventure. You don't get this back home. Think I'm crazy? Well, wax on this is my shoes. You'll feel the same thing. Sure. So do you think we can rehabilitate society with settlements like this? Smiles and waves away your question. Yeah, right. The Westerns will soon have rehabilitated us, dear colleague. Here, whereas there's freedom, everything changes. Mute up to keep up with the times. Ideologically, like the one atoms are stale in the short term. Sure. Any advice? Nothing too weird. For example, I've heard that some settlement near a dead sea was terrorized by a giant snail. You know what? The locals started making knives and spearheads out of the sea salt. That's the moral of the story. Know your surroundings and use your wits instead of your blunt force. That's actually a good thing. Okay, nothing else? Right. We'll be later on. So, Pasha. Pasha is the guy who can actually help us build this thing. And I think he was somewhere over here. I think I found him. What an unshaved man sits in a bottle-filled table and looks into you, into an empty glass. Your rival lifts him up a bit.
Hey there, Commander! What's up?
It's okay, who are you?
Well, don't you know who I am, Chief? I'm Pasha, Pasha the Technician. Gozonki sent me to the place to help you out with such.
Okay, how can you help me?
Look, I fixed this place for you, right? But I never touched the downstairs. There's so much work. It's downright scary, but... Chief, if you pay me the parts, I'll fix it up.
I'll fix you, your pump to get water level down. 500 rubles should be enough. But if you're too greedy for that, you may try to clean it yourself.
Pasha has a great offer. Pasha is the kind of a person. That's one that has only great offers.
500 rubles. I try to repair it myself. There are critters down there. Dude, you honestly think I'm afraid of some critters? I mean, come on. Where do you know Gashin from? He found me, barely breathing, inside of a huge garbage container. It's funny to remember, but back then, when it happened, I was scared witless. I think I've passed off some members to the, of the Pack Gang. Of the gang Pack North. They beat me up, they threw me in, and decided to bury me alive. Then Gashin happened by. He was there to trade, he said. You boys are up to no good, threatening people like that. Don't you know you're doing the devil's will? Anyway, he bought me from those bastards. He bought you, so technically speaking, you're my property. Since then, I'm an agent of Atom too. Okay. Right, so let's go downstairs and try to fix the stuff. Well, back to the bunker. So where exactly are those critters, man? The only thing I see are mushrooms. I don't think the mushrooms are actually critters. Okay, let's take a look around. Maybe I have to like look for something. I just hope I won't get poisoned from the mushrooms, because that would be sad. That would be so sad. Oh, something over here. What's this? Woo! Okay, just don't step into the mushroom. There you go. Thank you for the pills. Right. So where exactly is the... Okay, that's one thing. Is that the thing I need to fix? Wait, what? Oh! Oh, I think this is the thing I need to poison. Wait, what? Ah, shit. I walk it probably into the fucking fungi. Crap! Okay. Well, let's try to fix the... The engine's not working. Must be fixed. Information? You see a pump. Okay, try to repair it. Success! Who needs a specialist? I just saved 500 rubles. Yeah! Would you look at that? Water is depleting. Nice! No. Oh. See, the water actually have disappeared. That's nice. Okay, so what the heck is this thing then? Is this supposed to be some water filter? What's this thing? It's a generator. Okay, try to fix it. What I can say? I'm a golden man! And now it's working! Yay! So outside of the poisoning, I've actually managed to fix a bunch of stuff. Oh, Pasha! I don't think I'm gonna need you for long, you know. I'm here about the pump.
Like I said, Chief, pay it for the parts and I'll fix the pump to clear the water down. 500 rubles.
Dude, the pump fixes already. What's next?
Oh? Well, since there is no more water down there, we can check out the generator without the risk of getting a joint. This will cost you 500 rubles. Or you can try to repair it yourself. Fix it already. What's next?
Generator's fixed, of course, but poisonous fungi make food work a bit challenging. Yeah, notice it. We need to dispose them, Chief. Pasha combs his hair with his hands and stretches out his legs under the table. Before you could technically success on your own, now only I can help you out. But removing poisonous mushrooms is no easy task. I need 500 rubles. Okay, so the previous jabs... I'm getting a bad feeling. Yeah, because you poisoned it. Okay, you want 1,000 rubles? Here. Everything will be amazing, Chip. Come back in a day. You pass the money to the technician. Upon putting on the makeshift gas mask he gets inside the bunker, the lid closes behind him. We'll see. I could do it myself, I think. Oh, what the shit? Hello. Smiling man holding a huge walking stick looks at the giant head of cows grazing on the green pastures of Red Fighter. The scene is so innocent, a pastoral, it reminds you of a time long before rural folk even imagined a nuclear war was underway. This illusion quickly shatters as the man waves at you with his mutilated hand, dark, red, terribly burnt, and with all five fingers fused to get in a solid, cautious lump.
Good health to you, master! You got carried to the road? Those days have a bit of a road, and the forest is filled with the con artists, bandits, and drug abusers of all sorts. But don't you worry, the milk from my
from any witch of my mumu will cure all of your illness. About said cows, actually. You're probably thinking, who's the guy and what are his cows doing here? Well, I'm here simply because Comrade Gozefurt invited me. He even gave me a written permission to stay here for a while. Well, that's nice. Now, what is it? God damn it!
Zarya probably chewed up a little when I wasn't looking. She's a beautiful cow, but she loves to eat paper, especially the bureaucratic kind. Anyway, Comrade Gozefurt, let us stay here because he thought you would be interested in hiring me and my herd.
And what I will gain for that? If you hire me, I'll stay right here in your village. I'll buy tools needed for building and grass cutting. If you spare me 100 rubles, I'll cut your grass for the cows to eat during winter. I've herded the cows too. And here is the best thing. Those mumus will be constantly free for all who live here. Everyone will be able to milk them for free. Okay. Sure. Here. 100 rubles is like, I piss on that amount. Okay, thank you. You won't ever regret it. I'll use your money to buy the tools I need to settle here. And now, you can now milk the cows as much as you like. Just don't kill them. Meat spoils, but fresh milk is a readable resource. Wait, what? I got resource management now? What the heck is happening with this game? Pasha got out of the sex dungeon, so let's see what he has to say. Pasha looks at the bottle. Okay, whatever. How's Chief? You need the fuel to generator too. Wait, what? Sure thing, Chief. 500 rubles and I will make the order. You can bring me around 100 bottles of fuel, but who in the right mind would do that? I will, probably. That's for sure. Now then, let's make it happen. Okay, I'll remember that thing. Maybe actually I'll be able to find fuel, you know, since I'm attacking the caravans, stuff like that, so. But I wonder, because now the bunker should be safe, right? Would you look at that? Mushroom free! Oh! Wait, was this thing before? This is weird. Okay, the thing is that I cannot really put anything inside here, so that's a bummer. Okay, we need to store somewhere my equipment. Because this is a thing I constantly have a problem with. Getting completely overwhelmed with wave from all the armors and weaponry that I'm carrying around is actually starting to be a fucking ass issue. So let's see, can I store here weaponry, for example? Please tell me I can store weaponry here at least. Yeah, I think I can. Right, so I think we got all of the weapons I need on me. Right? Yeah, most of them at least. I got some really advanced weapons, by the way. 7.62 ammo. Okay, this is 545. I'm not sure. Okay, I'm gonna leave probably some of the weapons, that's for sure. Right, let's do something like this. I'm gonna drop here all of my weapons that I have. So I can actually make some space, you know. I'm just gonna unload the ammo, because I'm gonna take the ammo with me. For obvious reasons. Okay, let's leave this thing, let's leave this thing, let's leave this thing. Just unload all of the weapons. Okay, those don't have any ammunition, so that's great, I guess. The pistol, I think I'm gonna take this pistol with me. I'm not sure that I have a better pistol or I have a worse pistol. Hold on a second. This one makes from 8 to 14, this one makes, yeah, okay, this one's a bit better. Alright, time to swap pistols. Unload the ammo for this one. Oh, because this one's a rusted one. That's why this thing is worst. Right. Any of you? Yeah, you have a pistol as well. So put it over there. Give me the ammo. You have the shotgun thingy. So unload it. Put it over there. The hunter rifle thingy. The pistol. Okay, put it over there. Another pistol. Who would have guessed that I have so many pistols? Holy shit. Another sniper rifle, I mean hunting rifle, another one of those pistols, another hunting rifle, rusty AK. Oh my god, I can open myself an armory over here. That's nice. Okay, rusty shotgun thingy, whatever. Another rusty shotgun thingy, whatever. Let's see what else we have over here. Yeah, okay, those, whatever those things. Homemade assault rifles look pathetic. Okay, this is going actually quite nice. Now, I got a bunch of armor items that I can actually give to my people. So, Fidel, you're gonna get one, that's for sure. Yeah, there you go.
You're gonna be a lot tougher with this thing, baby.
Holy fuck, ladies and gentlemen, it feels so good to be so light. I've unloaded all of the weapons, I've unloaded all of the armors. Actually, I should probably take some of those armors, maybe for selling. But then again, maybe we should try to go some caravan hunting.
Let's go caravan hunting.
Another thing that for the future knows is that we will have to do is that I have to travel to the bunker. Now, I've once wanted to explore this thing. We have to eventually get over here to the bunker 317. And that's to the far north of my current position. So, okay, let's try to do some, you know, scouting around. Let's just follow the road and see if we find anything interesting. And probably, I don't know why I tried to do it today. Maybe I'm actually gonna try to venture there today. But the actual bunker, I think I'm gonna set that thing for the next episode. Slave hunters. Sure, let's try to attack them and see how this thing is gonna go. But holy fuck, nobody told me I'm gonna get surrounded right away. Oh my god. God, this is just lovely. This is just super lovely. Okay, aim head. Let's try to shoot the head. That's a critical shot in the head. That's great, but guess what? I cannot do anything else. Oh, this is gonna be bad. I'm surrounded by fucking slavers. Oh no, this is not gonna end good. Yep, we're gonna die now. Great. This game has no chill, at least back in Fallout. You spawn at one side, the enemy spawn at on the other side. And this one is like, oh, fuck you. You're gonna get surrounded from the very first seconds of the encounter. So screw you. I hope you have a gigantic health pool. Because if you're not, well then, I hope how you know how to there you go. This is what I wanted to see. Please tell me you are an armored caravan. Come on, weaponry. Please tell me you have weaponry. Oh, yeah. actually, no. You just have food. That's not exactly good. But then again, I need to try to level up my squad a little bit because they are so on the leveled right now. Nice shot. Almost dead right away. I would love to have one more action point, you know. Cannot perform a single shot. That is probably the worst thing. Yo, guys, start to shoot, you know. Because they are coming for us and holy shit, that guy is healing. Why all of a sudden everybody has access to fucking healing materials? Can someone please... Nice shot! Stop shooting your own teammate, you idiot! Good news is that I've managed to kill two guys at the same time with critical shots. Just don't shoot my own teammate, thank you. Alright. Holy shit, I'm good at this game. Nice. The only thing I'm wasting is ammo. Another caravan dead. I am a terrible person. I wonder what exactly is this thing, because normally when you see something like this, that means there is some type of a encampment over here. So I wonder who we're gonna meet this time. And I'm actually not that far away from the bunker itself. You approach a farm you noticed some time ago. It seems to be inhabited and by honest folks, since gangsters really rarely raise cattle, preferring instead to ride their neighbors. The silence is broken from time to time by the sounds of an obnoxious hen or a boarded cow. However, you remain on alert. Who can guess the customs of the people who managed not only to survive but also raise cattle and crops in the godforsaken place? The harsh clack of rifle bolt slinking the place suggests this question will be answered sooner rather than later.
Freeze! Who are you? Where do you come from? Who are you looking for?
You feel the cold stare of a tall, well-built, blue-eyed girl dressed in a tattered camouflage uniform. The bore of her tightly held gun is pointed right between your eyes. Don't shoot, have mercy, I'm merely exploring the area. Easy, okay, I'm just exploring this thing. Takes your hands off your weapon and put on a peaceful face. The girl quickly raises her gun and you instantly step back. Then she lowers the weapon, smile playing on her lips.
Calm your wife down, not me.
When she realizes just how big of a piece of shit she married, at least you have a chance to look on the grill properly. The first thing you notice makes you feel weird. The fighter who's just challenged you is no more than 20. You look like a half... You look like you have more genes of a man than you have of a woman. And I'll have to think about you, explorer. You don't look like the one of the local gangsters, but you can't pass for a merchant either. This is the problem. I would have allowed a merchant through, not questions asked. Father needs some stuff. Mom has some orders, and even the little one have been petitioning us about the merchants going to visit. Okay, I suppose you're Herbert, no ill intent. What are you after? I want nothing, I came here by mistake. But since I'm here, would you mind telling me about yourself? The gear frowns and adjusts her impressive looking gun belt. That depends on what you're interested in. I've been boring as hell recently, and I wouldn't mind a nice chat. But that doesn't mean I want to talk Bullshit. Who are you? Okay, her name is Alyonka. Alyonka. Where I came from, the what? Where I came from and what for it is to the big boss of the cloud to know. Okay. This isn't my real family. I just live with them. I protected them from riots, usually alone. More out of the habit than love of the point. What's your name? It's simple. My name is unimportant. Okay, let's just... Big Matt Mutha! Right. Glad to meet you. Yeah, likewise. Who are you? Oh, okay. What you doing here? Well... I had the civil defense of this poverty stricken farm. The family has supported me ever since I was orphaned. Under circumstances that remain a mystery, in return I helped them rebuff the attacks. I have no idea where I learned how to shoot. It seems that as I was born with the thing in my hands. You look like a man! Okay, good. I got some experience points. Because of me, they don't show their noses around here. Most of the local gangs have decided it's not worth the effort. This family has almost nothing to take, and anyone who tries is going to lose at least one or two men before they get to me. The only one who still gives us trouble is Stefan Balagan, but I sort of understand him. His elder brother was sent to the sky, richly and figuratively, after tripping one of the mines. That's call for revenge. So you have mines around this place, good to know. If you can pay, I might know a way to... make this Stefa lie low. As in 6 feet under low. Shakes her hand. No. I will not tolerate no interference to the matter. You think Stefa is broke? If he wanted, he could hire a gang to shell our farm with grenades or a sniper to silence me. But he doesn't because he wants to deal with me himself. In person. When he comes out of the hall, I'll be more than happy to have a little chat with him. Love, and you bet your right arm, that's love this girl dream's eyes are full of, sometimes finds a trick way into people's life. Alright. Tell me about the farm. It's a stinky hole. Makes covered sense, the house is lopsided. We have gangsters pasturing us. You have a right, you have to ride for days to get supplies or help or anything else. Yet this land belongs to us. And that means something. Sure. You said you didn't mention. Why? There are 20 cartridges in here, and when they run out, what then? There'll be another riot. I know it. Stefa Balagan and his cutthroats have been silenced too long. They must have been preparing something nasty. I need at least 20 handcuffs of gunpowder. I've been saving up quite a while, but in a month since I placed my order, the merchant hasn't come. I'll give you this money to you if you return the gunpowder before he does. I'll even add a small bonus. Deal? Sure, if I find this many gunpowder. Alright. I'll be on my way then. Okay, let's explore. Would you look at that? It's a little farm. You build a fucking farm in the middle of a road. Oh my god. Do you know that this is a terrible place to put some bloody ass vegetables? Oh, a cow. How lovely. Okay. So, any of you want to speak with me? Sad-looking, gray-haired man with elderly eye, heavy from exhaustion or alcohol, claps you on the shoulder.
Hello, hello. Who brought you here? Something good? I can tell. My own, or my little terrorist would have made a big hole in you.
This is in a way, nice way that you named the only defender of this. Sorry for a call farm. Little terrorist mentioned in the merchant. Always so attractive to everyone needs. I feel ashamed next to this. But this is an occasion where she is wrong. I don't need a merchant anymore. I want to buy new weights. And then dug up a motorcycle trailer in the garden. I can sell weights myself now. Okay, where's? Wait, what? What he needs? He needs a private detective. Well, you know. Detective or a pathologist. So. People say there's a guy walking around those lands who introduced himself as Karlov, the tourist. But he's no tourist, you understand? He's not interested in our cities and villages. What's remain of our architecture is all the same to him. What he pays attention to is our woman, you got me? People say he's convinced at least 30 women in the Kazadimi alone for his horizontal mambo. I'm afraid he might have seduced my wife. I'm not always home, sometimes I cross the border to visit my family or spend the night fishing, and she's here alone. Try and understand me, friend. We've been having the rough already, and if she's cheating on me with this car glove, I have to know. As for checking, it's easy. The bloody Casanova gives a plastic ring to every woman he seduces, as a keepsake. So if you could rummage through her things and find a ring, it would all be clear as a day. Could you do this thing for me? Sure, I just love to go through your wife's private blowings. That's the thing I do as a hobby. Right, okay, let's see. Where's the wife, though? Oh my god, that's... Okay, I'm guessing this is the wife, and she's probably guarding that thing. Okay, let's see this. Nothing here. Let's see this. Ooh, it's locked. Would you look at that? Unlock. Oh! Okay. Right, so that's the wife, I'm guessing. Oh, would you look at that. Welcome to the farm! Who are you? I was just passing by. The girl at the gate mentioned you didn't mention. Since sand plagues spread across our fields, our cattle have felt very bad. We need a... What? Okay, it's a human medication, but people say it helps animals too. 5 packs at least. If you help us, I will be extremely grateful, young man. I have the money to pay, and of course, a little extra for your effort. Okay, so you need my pills that I use. Sure, I can help you. Good news. Here, have the money. I save it up for this. Let me have the look at this. You haven't paid me that much. She transfers the money. Yada yada. Looks wonderful. Thank you so much. I just need to use this magical substance wisely, and no parasite will threaten my cattle. Yeah, probably. Okay, you're selling toilet paper. That actually gives me a lot of information about you. What's this place? What do you do here? Nothing of interest. For the most part, I left. I look after dump. Intriguing beasts. And a cattle too, of course. Sure. You gonna leave this thing, maybe? Come on, please tell me you're gonna leave the house. Because I would love to just check your belongings, woman. No. She's gonna stay there. Fuck. Oh my god, that's a nice girl. Hi. Where are you from? From Earth, and this must be paradise, for I see an angel in front of me. After a couple of seconds, the girl looks at you with an uncomfortable expression on her face. Before she bursts into loud laughter. You're a complete idiot. Uncle? I thought you were a wandering warrior or something, and here you are, making passes. Well, don't see any consternation. Can I ask you a couple of questions? No, you can't. The girl says, laughing, turns ugly and presents she's going to walk away. But the last moment she turns back, a shy smile plays on her lips. Okay, you can, but don't expect any interesting answers. Right. The woman on the gate mentioned you all need a merchant here. She's being a morang again. What do I care if he comes or not? As if I had money. I'm just a child. Maybe she hears me complaining that there is no one even to talk in this hole. You've come from the big world, right? Tell me how it is. Better than here, I can tell you. There are problems, true, but that's plenty of fun too. Same as here, fighting for survival, hunger, poverty. You're lying. It just can't be as boring as everywhere else. It just can't. You'll be surprised. Unless you're hunting down caravans, and actually it's not that boring. I've taken a little break, and I've actually, you know, rested a little bit, and I waited for the night, and the woman went to sleep, so now I can actually go through their things. Okay, I have one of the lock, and there you go, plastic ring. How did I know that this is gonna happen? Okay, what about this thing? Unlock. Failed to open the lock. Failed to open the lock. No, not this thing. There you go. And what's inside of this? Atom pass. Wait, what? Old passport of an Atom member. Just like yours. This one is signed Balolos Antony Palovivich. You should hold on to this memorabilia. Wait, what the fuck? You wanna tell me that this guy is a member of Atom? Okay, hold on a second. I'm gonna save and ask him what the fuck is this Atom card. Dude, what the actual shit? The man squints and examines the card. I found it. With Alenka, our forest daughter. This is all I know, and I don't want to continue this conversation at all. Next time, maybe. Fine. Listen, about your wife and your tourists. Okay, maybe, actually, hold on a second. If you're gonna speak with the woman first, can we actually tell her that you found the key? Okay, she doesn't want to talk with me. Alright, so I'm gonna rest. It's really late, so let's see. Let's rest for 6 hours. Let's rest for another 6 hours. There you go, daytime. Okay, let's see. Woman. What do you want to talk about? I know your secret. Okay, hold on a second. I'm gonna save again, because I don't feel like destroying a marriage, okay, in the middle of the fucking wastes. Right. The woman casts a short glance on the ring and shouts. This is my jackass husband who sent you. What do you want? A ransom for the silence, long man? Barter. Silence is golden. But I'll give you a discount. It costs you 200 rubles. I've come to tell you to hide it better. I just wanted to look the unfaithful wife in the eye and glimpse remorse. The woman laughs, but her laugh is bitter. You wish to see fear or regret? You won't, young man. I'm too tired for my responsibilities to regret the bridges burnt. You can bring him to the trinket this very moment if you want. I won't take this personally. Seriously, this won't affect my attitude towards you either. Expect, maybe in a positive way. Such delicate detective work should be respected. Okay. Okay, if you don't care. Hey, dude, I found you fucking thingy. Give him the plastic ring. Your space was absolutely groundless. Your wife has never cheated on you. Okay, what's gonna happen if I'm gonna tell him about the ring? He looks in fear. Thank you. Good job. Here's your reward. This is all I have. Wow. Not much, but what you can do. Thank you. And stay strong, mate. I wonder, will she change? You again? Okay, I have questions. Right, nothing changed. I wonder, will he actually throw her out? That'll be hilarious. My daughters are leaving. My wife is leaving. What will I do? What? Is that you? Sorry, I'm busy now. Oh! They're all leaving him. Oh, whoops, a mistake I've been made. So what's gonna happen if I'm gonna tell him that your wife have never cheated on you? The man smiles happily and claps you on the shoulder. Great news indeed. His face goes gray. You're absolutely sure, right? You've checked it properly. You checked it well. Of course you did. You wouldn't lie. Your eyes are like the eyes of a forest daughter. Honest. Eyes of a warrior. Here's a present for you. For all your trouble. Let's talk about this no more. Gives me 30 rubles, okay? Take the reward and leave without saying goodbye. Cheer up. Okay, and let's speak with the wife now. Apparently I cannot. Okay, so I should have give her the ring sooner. Oh well. Screw her, I guess. Right. My daughters are leaving. My wife is leaving. Wait, what? Oh, come on! So what's gonna happen if I'm gonna give her the ring? I've come to told you to hide it better. Give her the ring. Don't cocks her eyebrow a bit. Who would have thought? It wasn't quite that I expected, but thank you. I got very attached to this trinket. After all, it's a symbol of my independence from this lodge. He will learn about what I did anyway. I want him to. Great! But still, thank you. And let's leave it at that, okay? Sure! What you have brought to me? Okay, so I cannot talk with him about the... Well, at least his wife is not leaving him, so that's great. Right? Oh, fuck, I need to eat again. Okay, I'm gonna go outside of the map, or actually speak with Alyonka. Okay, nothing over here. Okay, let's leave the map and, you know, we're gonna walk around a little tiny bit and then we're gonna return and see did his wife leave him. Good news! The daughters are still around! The husband is still alive! That's nice! Okay, nothing we can say to him, and the wife is still around, so yay, everything is happy family. And if I'm gonna find the Casanova, I'm just gonna fucking murder him. I found myself some scavengers, and apparently you guys don't have to happen a core border or start started for the ignition. Wait, is this thing necessary for fix the car? 5,000 rubles? I know this part costs much less. No, it doesn't. Okay, can I just kill you for that? I don't have this thing here. Okay, you know what? I'm just gonna try to murder you. And I'm not gonna give a two shits about it. So, please tell me you have the part. No, you don't. Shit, that wasn't worth it. The ammunition I wasted for you was worth a lot more than this. So I have to actually buy the part for 5,000.
Well, shit.
Honestly, I have to buy ignition for 5,000 rubles. I shooted the guy, the scavenger, and he didn't have the stupid ass item with him. I don't. This is just like, why? I understand that the game just does not allow me to cheese my way through completely, but okay, we're gonna meet the scavengers again. Right, this time I'm gonna play nice and I'm gonna actually buy this crap from them. Oh my god, man, 5,000 rubles for this thing. Right, you guys don't have an ignition thingy? Ah, shit. He doesn't have this thing now. Son of a... What the fuck? Armored. Yo! Armor for a dog? Well, this is my lucky fucking day. Holy shit. Okay, do they have anything else useful? I don't think so. Okay, I'm gonna sell you one of the armors I have acquired through a... caravan trading. Yeah, that's exactly the thing I wanted to say. Caravan trading. Where is that stupid ass armor? Where is that shit? Did I sell it by mistake to somebody? Oh no. I think I sold it to somebody by mistake. Okay, whatever. I'm gonna sell you this thing then. And what else we could trade to sell you? Some crap, probably. You don't have anything that could remotely be useful for me, you know that? Okay, you need gunpowder, you need this thing, you need this thing. Right, there's nothing else we could try to do with that thing. I think I can get myself actually a newspaper. Because I've heard that the newspaper actually is gonna be useful for something. People didn't want to tell me what. So it's like, yeah, gather that newspaper, boy. Gather it. You want to know what's happening in the fucking wastelands. It's like, okay. I don't have anything to give you back. And I refuse to pay you with money. Because I love money. Son of a bitch. I don't know what to sell you. Shit. This is not good. Okay, let's see what this thing actually works for the dog. Hold on a second, where's the thingy? There it is. This time is gonna work. Fuck yeah! Oh look, he actually has a little vest on himself. Oh, that's so cute! Nice. What the fuck, I wanted to leave my fucking camps and what the heck is this? What the fuck is that thing? I've made myself a little camp, set to prepare some food. I wanted to leave this thing and all of a sudden this thing jumping out to me. 200 experience points. What the fuck was that? Leshy. Okay, I am leaving this place right fucking now. Met another group of scavengers, so maybe this time I'm gonna be a bit more lucky. Come on, boys, tell me you have the ignition. Yes, you have. Okay, hold on a second. Let me swap my... equipment. There you go. So now I'm actually more trustworthy because I have a fucking hat. Ah, fuck. Okay. Right. You want 5,000? Here. Just give me the damn thing. It's yours. Just plug it and there you go. Great. Please tell me I got the money that I just trade to you. You don't even have the money that I just give it to you. Why game? Why do you do something like this to me? I really hope that this car is gonna be worth it, you know? 5,000 for a fucking ignition. Screw you guys. Who the fuck is this guy? Lady, whatever, I don't care. Alrighty, so what? Good morning. You got a mail. Wait, what? Mail? Mail guy? Yo, Mr. Post guy, what the fuck? Hello? Can I ask you some questions? What you busy with? I deliver mail. Dangerous work. Who you work for? The Chamber of Commerce of Krasidimi, the local government, the other ones. Their seat of power, as you can tell by the name. Okay, so is there a lot of mail to deliver? You wouldn't believe it. I barely cope with the amounts. I'm always asking the bosses to hire more postmen because other people look at and the idea of creating a postal service, they soon learned how great it really is. So now I'm delivering hopes of documents, letters of inquiry, and even love letters all over the place. People really are social animals. Who are you? I spend most of my time on the road, moving from village to village. Isn't it scary to travel alone? It is pretty scary. The roads are stalked by hungry dogs and wolves. There are also monsters nobody ever seen before the war. Not to mention the bandits. I was shot, I was knifed, I was punched and I was bitten. But I'm still alive and kicking! Yeah, not for long. Especially if we're gonna meet this one guy who runs around the... True, with two teammates with red helmets and shoots everybody around. Especially the caravans. Wait, huh? Do you care to ban? Ooh, you have ammo. Okay. Thank you. trade. Okay, why I have this super feeling that he's going actually to the shop owner that I've promised that I will speak on his behalf back in Kazadimi? I think it is. Empty as always, nobody's sending anything. Hmm. Well, apparently I was wrong. Whoops. Wait, maybe I should follow him. Maybe? You gonna do something funny? Good morning, just passing by to say hello. No mail today. Okay, Katya, how things are going? Could you possibly lend me some money for funds? No, I don't think so. Okay, I don't think she has anything interesting whatsoever at the moment. Right, so this guy just goes around and delivers mail. Okay, interesting. Right, trader. How about a discount since I'm new to in the town? Yeah, just as I. You have a letter from a mysterious admirer. Okay, I'll be back later. What? Mysterious admirer? Hi, Doc.
You again? Feeling low?
Yeah, listen, I need to help, Doc. No. Listen, how about a small discount on the drugs I'm buying? How's life? Okay, nothing interesting over here. How's the job? He got a letter and yet I cannot get any info out of him because of that letter. Interesting. I wonder, is this supposed to be just a random event or is actually important for something? I have no damn idea. Okay, let's visit the shop. Please tell me you have some ammo for me. Come on, please tell me I can buy ammo for you. Come on. Give me ammo. You have such a pathetic weapon. This is just unbelievable. Advice from the toilet, 01. Recipe. Okay, advice from the toilet, 05. Okay, gasoline. I need gasoline or I need diesel. I wish I remember, but I don't. I need one of those, that's for sure, but why you don't have any ammo? Oh, gun that's actually modified, that's nice. Okay, I'm gonna buy those recipes, because recipes are always good to have. Let's get any ammo you have. Okay, you don't have any ammo in this one, seriously? Shit. You are the worst possible vendor ever. I have never served such a pathetic vendor in my entire fucking ass life. Holy shit, why are you so bad? Let's give the ignition to the old admiral or whatever his name is. Comrade? Whatever. Oh, I need two items. Ah, fuck. Let's take a look at my loot. Sure, let's see what you got. Look at what I have found. Okay, wait, so this thing count? Do I need two items now or I just need one item because I have no damn idea? You are a true magician. Yeah, I know I'm a true fucking magician. Okay, give him the item that was worth 5 fucking thousand to me. Great, anything else? That's all, I should go. Yes, I need two different items. And he's gonna be back to repairing the car. Okay, that's nice. Let's go back to my old hideout over here. And because I think I've stored a few items here and there, which would be I would love to actually take back to my main base now. Unless there's something I left in the fucking lockers? There you go, see? I knew I left a bunch of this crap over here. One day I have to solve the mystery of this thing, whatever this thing is. Quite the toy, it must be a nutcracker, right? But where's your sword? No, he's not a nutcracker. How I can give... Because I have an item, right? One second. I got an item, the wooden AK thingy. Burst. Don't see the target. What? No! Ow, no, what? No, don't attack! Oh, shit. Guys, that was a toy. Oh, whoops. Yeah, good job, Fidel. You just fucking lost a bunch of hit points because of you, idiot. I just found that this rock can be interacted with. Literally outside of the shack. Right, it seems I cannot move this rock unless I get help. Shovel, use the shovel as a lever to shift the rock aside. Wait, what? Bloody hell. I broke the shovel. Strength? Okay. Examine the rock. The person who caught the intos into the stone was lightened, but clearly no mentioned. It's unskilled work done with makeshift tools. The boulder looks suspicious, like a gravestone. Right. What difficulties for one person is a piece of cake for a team. Altogether, you make an effort to move the rock aside. That was hard. Piece of a shield. Boris Chekhov's journal. The fuck? What in the fuck is this thing? Drunken lair. Last will be confession of the so-called museum curator, Boris Fekalov, written with utter self-hatred by his own hand. Okay, is this supposed to be some part of a quest or something? Piece of a shield. Okay, I'm gonna take this thing. I'm guessing this is related to a maybe a hidden quest or something like that, you know, like an Easter egg. This happens actually from time to time. So maybe that's actually another thing. Yo, how's the car? Can you actually fix this thing today? Where I can find the starter. A duty trader named Dmitry Admirov will have such items. He's continuing staying at Krasidimi Hotel, but I suggest trying the scavengers first. Yeah, okay, I've already tried the scavengers first, and you know what? It cost me fucking 5,000. To be honest with you, I've tried to, you know, accumulate the amount of fuel that this guy requires from me, Pasha, but that's impossible. You need fuel, right? 5,000 rubles. Sure, okay, make it happen. You pass the money. I'll come back in 3 days, don't worry, the money will be put to good use. I hope so. Because if not, then I'll have to kill you, probably. Right, where is the commander in charge of this place? Where is he? Where is that other guy? Yo, did he left? Hello? Okay, maybe this is his home. Maybe he went home? I hope so. Because I don't fucking see him anywhere. What is that idiot? That's some idiots. I'm looking for the guy who actually is responsible to run this thing, as I am not here most of the time. I think that's him? Yeah, that's his. Okay. Found him! No need to worry any longer. Alright. The main thing is to stay positive. Yeah, sure, woman. Just ignore the radiation, the dust storms, the mutants, the bandits, everything else. Yeah, sure. What's the worst that could possibly happen in the wastelands? In such a small village like this one that literally have no defenses whatsoever. Right, what's new in the settlement? Only you and Pasha the technician, no matter. Once we settle here, people will come. Okay. Right, so apparently nothing new has happened. Good to know, but I need to cook myself some food, so how about we're gonna get ourselves some canned meat? Delicious. Since the guy will be back in 3 days, I have some time to actually move towards the bunker that we want to explore for the future missions. So I'm gonna do exactly that thing, and I kinda hope I'll be able to... There you go. Because the caravans are exactly the people we wanted to meet. Yo, guys, I have some armor, so I would love if you could buy from me. Oh, great, he's an ammo dealer. Sweet, okay. Can you please give me all of your ammunition? Because I would love to collect bullets. I'm a huge fan of collecting bullets, you know that? Oh my god! Right. Okay, unload this thing. Give me the bullets. Thank you. Right, I don't think I have... Wait, hold on a second. How many of you are there? Oh, no. Okay, actually, there's a bunch of them. Right, so forget the idea I have. Now, please tell me how much the armor is worth for you. One armor is worth 400 rubles. That's okay. So I can actually buy all of the ammo and at the same time get rid of some of the items I don't want any longer in my inventory. Okay, this thing. I don't know why exactly I'm collecting that type of ammo. I'm not using it actually that much. Right, and this is not even close to the amount worth of this armor. Shit. Come on, dudes. Pay up better a little bit, huh? Come on, I know you can do it in your life. Okay, how about I'm gonna get you some coffee? Okay, I'm gonna later on make myself some coffee. Yeah. Thank you. Much appreciated. And how about you're gonna go and fuck yourself? And we are back to the lovely little farm in the middle of a fucking road. Listen, woman, I got you... Okay, hold on a second. I think I have to transfer the gunpowder to myself. There you go. Okay. You wanted gunpowder? Here. I got your gunpowder.
Really? Come on, let me see. You want money? Here's your money.
Okay, right, so she gave me 300 rubles.
All hope, all lost, all hope before this. Thank you.
Had it not been for you, I've been digging traps all across the farmstead. Now I have gunpowder to defend myself in case of a riot. Need anything else? There is no problem in my life that extra cartridge won't solve, and you helped me with that already. You handle firearms like a gunsmith, yet none of your family seems to know anything about them. Don't you feel lonely here? Come off of it, I'm not a gunsmith. I know a thing or two about guns, sure, but no more. As of loneliness, no. Through, I do sometimes wonder what life with my real family would be like. I was adopted and no one here shares my hobbies or interests. They can't even properly explain how I got here. Father says he found me in the forest, walking alone to God knows where. What do you remember from that day? I remember difficult. The memories are vague, of course, but I remember a deep ravine, three roots poking out of the wall like withered arms. There's a man with me in the ravine. He has a mustache, but no beard, and I know him. He's armed with a gun. A Kalashnikov, I think. There's loud noise, screams. He sticks his head out of the shot, then throws a grenade. Someone is shooting back at us. The earth is rocking. My hands are so tiny, a toddler hands, and I'm holding a Makarov pistol, trying to reload. At first, it's clumsy, but I get faster and faster, and then there's a blow. That's it. I don't remember a damn thing after that. I've tried to talk to Dad about the news, but it must be a dream, yada yada, okay. His story is quite unusual. Okay, if I'm learn. Okay, talking about your parentage. Fell around in your pocket for the Atom membership card. Okay, so should we tell her that we, you know, are from Atom? What about it? I could find no evidence to confirm your story and no information about who your family might be. You found this card in your foster father's things. Your biological parents might have been members of Atom. I recognize this face. This is my dad, my little dad. We fought some rascals to get in the ravine. He must have been hit by a grenade. Rostrov family found me and gave me a shelter. This is how. But wait, what do you mean, Atom? That's nothing but a story. There's no such an organization. It doesn't exist. This is what I'm talking about, not their nonsense. There's no such thing as Atom. It's nothing but the lies and the rumors of an existing are spread by Atom itself. Welcome back, sister. So, all this time, you from Atom? Do you know my parents?
No.
But I know where you get your answers. Give her the coordinates of the base. Okay, so I can get her into my village, or I can tell her to go the main base. I can also tell her to join me. How about you're gonna go to the village? Of course. So Red Fighter is an Atom stronghold now. I'll go there right now. Look after my family, please. I can't stay with them. And here's some food. Take it. Thank you again. Okay. I think that was a mistake. Yo, guys, you want to move to a good-ass village? Okay, so they're gonna probably die now. Sorry! Whoops! So that's our trip. Basically, I've made a little village in the... Well, a little farm, not a village. A little farm in the middle of nowhere. Lost their only protector. So that's like a thing. They're gonna probably die now. Oh, great. Caravan. They're gonna probably die now. We've started to build the village and now we are gathering fuel for the generator. So we have to return back to the base within the next 3 days. One day have passed. So I got 2 more days to venture into the bunker. Check it out and get back to headquarters and see did Pasha actually manage to gather some fuel. And then try to accept another quest from him. Then I think we're gonna try to go to Krasdimi. And still on the way here and there, I have to look for the stupid ass motherfucking parts for the car. How exactly is that gonna go? I have no damn idea. So that's gonna be probably the thing, ladies and gentlemen, that I'm gonna try to do during the future episode. Because for now, I'll just leave this thing as obvious. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed the next episode. Peace out. FCO! In the next video.